Hey everyone, it's Haley, and this is going to be my tour pass ranking slash review video for season 36's Deluxes Jukebox Jam. And honestly, we have some really great ones this season. Some impressive ones too. Including our first one here, A Dream of a Night in Mexico. I believe it's the small artist song of the season. First of all, I didn't really like it at first, but it only took like a day at the most to grow on me. It's a vibe, honestly. It's a banger. Might be one of my favorite alternative songs in the game, actually. Really unique, great instrumentals, unique vocals, stuff like that. Very pleasant listen. And the chart is actually the highest note count in the game for a hard currently, which is crazy. It's well over 800, and we've never had that before with a hard. It has plenty more notes than some extremes, standard and deluxe extremes, and it gave me a little bit of trouble to DP. Took like 5 to 10 attempts, I would say, but honestly, I love the chart. It's got so many 16th spams or what have ya. They are very satisfying to play. Drum rolls, obviously, doubles, some cool swipes, a little hold swipe slash rail hold section. It's really just awesome. Might be one of my new favorite hards, actually. Probably will come back to it a lot, and obviously it's memorable with how insane it is. So yeah, I love it, honestly. Let's get into it. Alright, next one is Faster Car. This is another song that I wasn't huge on at first, but I still liked it more than A Dream of a Night in Mexico. And now I really like it. Might sound a little generic, but that doesn't usually matter. A good song is a good song, and this is a good song. Really catchy, feels very happy. It's a great vibe. And the chart is simple and kind of easy for a hard, but so is the standard. They are both great, however. Lots of good hold swipes, rail holds, regular swipes, all that. And it has some fun double sections that are usually in separate lanes, specifically at the different song cut, the part that's not in the standard. The standard has a lot of doubles too, but in this one, they're mostly separated. But they don't feel too bad to play. I was supposed to sight read it, but I got hold ticked, missed 8 points. So be careful here. It's got a lot of easy spots to get hold ticked. I'm guessing it's the finger slash thumb placement can be tricky in some spots. But overall, this one is good. Although kind of easy. So let's get into it.
So small, watch the clock ticking off the wall. But tonight I'm letting it go. Spend my coin for show. I'm gonna be myself, or I could be someone else. No one's stopping me now. I'm gonna skip my breaks, I'm gonna make mistakes. I just wanna feel alive. It's just what I do when I'm out, so try not to hold me down. Feel alive when I'm in this town. Look at those beautiful stars. I wanna drive a faster car. Nothing can break me. No, no, nothing can break me. Try not to hold me down. Feel alive when I'm in this town. Look at those beautiful stars. I wanna take a trip to Mars. Nothing can break. Drive a faster car. I'm gonna be myself. I'm gonna be someone else. I'm gonna be myself. I'm gonna be someone else. I'm gonna skip my breaks. I'm gonna make mistakes. I'm gonna skip my breaks. I'm gonna make mistakes. I'm gonna be myself. I'm gonna be someone else. I'm gonna be myself. I'm gonna be someone else. I'm gonna skip my breaks, I'm gonna make mistakes. I'm gonna skip my breaks, I'm gonna make mistakes. Try not to hold me down. Feel alive when I'm in this town. Look at those beautiful stars. I wanna drive a faster car. Nothing can break me, no, no, nothing can break me. Try not to hold me down. Feel alive when I'm in this town. Nothing can break me, no, no, nothing can break me.
Alright, next we have Kill Bill, the popular TikTok song of the season, and the return of SZA. This is much better than Snooze, though. Honestly, the song's a vibe, even though it has very disturbing lyrics and even the title. Ignoring that, it's honestly a good song, especially for, you know, what it is, one of those popular TikTok songs, but I don't think it was too overplayed like some of the others. And the chart is decent too. It made a really good hard. I think the standard could have been a hard too, honestly, but probably an easy one like Snooze with maybe a few drifty parts or something. But yeah, it didn't turn out too bad. Good rap parts, swipes, rail holds. A lot of people were actually complaining about the rail holds because they switch. At the My Ex part, they switch as the words do. It's kind of hard to explain, but you'll see it. Honestly, I can understand that, but I don't think it's the end of the world. It's not like it doesn't flow. It's just a very weird way for it to flow. But yeah, overall, it's okay. I kind of like it. So, let's get into it.
to send it to my really lover. This text gonna be evidence. This text is evidence. I try to ration with you. No murder's a crime of passion. But damn, you was out of reach. You was at the farmer's market with your perfect peach. Now I'm in the basement, planning on my patient. Now you laying face down, got me singing over a beat. I'm so mature, I'm so mature, I'm so mature. I got me a therapist to tell me this other man. I don't want that, I just want you. If I can't have you, no one will.
Okay, next we have Lay Low, the return of Tiesto after, like, 33 seasons. And this one has grown on me, too. Probably the letdown of the season, in my opinion. At least chart-wise. It is quite simple. But overall, I think it's better than The Business, although that doesn't have a deluxe yet. Both charts have lots of fun swipes, doubles. Actually, can't remember if this has any rail holds in it. But regardless, it's alright. It kind of gave me trouble to DP because it's so slow. It is so slow. Hard to stay on beat when you're used to trying to move fast as I play extremes a lot. But yeah, it's alright besides that. And now that it's grown on me, I think the song might be just a little better than The Business. They're both just pretty decent, pretty good, maybe. But yeah, just kind of a forgettable one, but not terrible. So let's get into it.
They got me anytime, anywhere. My mind in the air. Da 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 da. Surround me. They surround me. Surround me. Anytime, anywhere. My mind in the air. They're waiting for me. They're calling on me.
Lay low, hit the sun. Everybody have a real good time. Yeah, we cool, yeah, we drunk. Lost my mind, and baby, I feel high. I feel high.
They're calling on me.
Lay low, hit the sun. Everybody have a real good time. Real good time.
Surround me.
Yeah, we cool, yeah, we drunk. Lost my mind, and baby, I feel high. I feel high.
They're calling on me. I'm hearing voices in my head. There's no way to escape. They got me. Anytime, anywhere. My mind in the air. Da-da-da-da. Surround me.
Lay low, hit the sun. Everybody have a real good time. Real good time. Yeah, we cool, yeah, we drunk. Lost my mind and baby, I feel high. I feel high.
They surround me. Surround me. Anytime, anywhere. My mind in the air. They're waiting for me. They're calling on me.
Lay low.
Alright, next we have Let's Play, The Return of Madsy. Lots of returning artists this season. Two EDM ones. And this is another one that has grown on me. The song might actually be better than What You Gonna Do. I totally thought the opposite at first, but it's not bad at all. And the chart, however, especially since it's a hard-to-hard rather than a hard-to-extreme like What You Gonna Do, is probably not as good, and it's not the most memorable thing. However, this deluxe actually has, I think, the longest rail hold in the entire game. And yeah, on my sight read, I was like, whoa, what is that? I couldn't believe how long it was. Doesn't feel as long anymore after playing it so many times, but still kind of crazy. And a cool addition. It does have some satisfying parts, just like the standard, some awkward gallops, and yeah, just stuff like that. But it's not bad. Some good swipes, I think some doubles. And overall, it's just another decent one that I'm probably not going to remember very well. So let's get into it. Alright, next we have Swamp Thing, our extreme of the season. Also the only deluxe extreme. However, it's the highest no count in the entire game with 983. It almost broke 1k, guys. I think eventually we're definitely going to get a chart that has 1k plus. I thought this one could be it, and almost, but not quite. Honestly, it's not the hardest extreme in the game, though, I don't think. Didn't take me too long to DP. Probably under 24 hours, unlike the standard that took me like all weekend. But yeah, in stage 4 it has a really strange rail hold part and rail hold swipes that feels like it goes on forever. It's the longest stage 4. At least it feels like the longest stage 4 in the game. you've got that part, and then you've got a crazy spam part with some triplets or whatever, and it goes in all lanes. It's insane. And part of it is in stage 3 as well. Until that part, it's kind of similar to the standard, though. Some diagonal swipes. That banjo part. Not much different, honestly. But yeah, then you get to those parts, and then the final stage. Well, going into the final stage, you've got like a hole right next to a down swipe, and then the stage tile. It's really strange. Gotta be careful which finger / thumb you use there. So that's weird. And then you go into the final stage with the clapping part. You'll know what I'm talking about. That goes on longer than the standard. And there are some swipes and doubles, just pretty much similar patterns to the standard, but more complex, obviously. And then before the banjo part, which is a different song cut than the standard, you've got like a little microtile triplet, and then one more microtile on the left lane. And then you've got the staircases again, just like the standard, but I honestly think they're easier to clear and get all perfect plus. Probably equally as fun to play, though. Yeah, honestly, it's just not that hard to DP compared to the standard, but not a cakewalk either, and overall I'm satisfied with it. So, not one of my favorites, but definitely a good and record-breaking one. In my opinion on the song, I just forgot to say it, sorry. I mean, at first I didn't love it, but I didn't hate it either. It is very repetitive and goofy. It's just unique, but it's great. I haven't seen many people hate on it. It's a goofy, awesome song. And the baby on the album cover looks very mischievous, just like the chart. And yeah, overall, it's just kind of a thriller, honestly. So let's get into it.
Well, all right, watch out.
Thank you.
All right, next we have the final countdown. The iconic banger of the season. Everyone loves and knows this one. Not much to say about the song itself. The chart? Oh my gosh. I had forgotten about the guitar solo that I saw a few people mention before the season released. And they did it justice in this deluxe chart. Micro tiles, staircase rhythms or patterns slash sweeps that are honestly a bit tricky because they slow down and it's hard to stay on beat, and some swipes, rail holds, you name it. The rest doesn't really stand out, honestly, but it's okay because that part is decently long and very fun. So this one does stand out from the crowd just for that. And an incredible improvement over the standard. Or improvement. Did I say improvement? Improvement over the standard. Which was not bad for a normal, but obviously nothing like this. So, really good overall. Let's get into it. Next is Wrecking Ball, the return of Miley Cyrus after, gosh, like 12 seasons, a dozen seasons. Season 24 was the last time. And yeah, that might have been the worst tour pass ever. This one honestly might be like one of the best though. So huge comeback there. And 23, when we first saw Miley Cyrus, was a good season too. So yeah, this might be her best song in the game. Really not sure. Malibu is definitely the worst, and most people would agree. This one is definitely another iconic one. Bangers in the album cover, which I think is pretty funny. And yeah, I think it's alright. So iconic that it's hard to hate, but yeah, just not my favorite, but I do kind of like it. And same with the chart. Obviously, it's a deluxe normal, so it's not going to be the most memorable thing, but it's not bad either. Lots of fun swipes, hold swipes, stuff like that to go with the vocals and everything. And I think a bit of a different cut that I wasn't expecting, but that was kind of cool too. So, just kind of a decent deluxe normal. Nothing like Don't Speak or Walking on a Dream. So, let's get into it.
We clawed, we chained our hearts in vain. We jumped, never asking why. We kissed, I fell under your spell of love. No one could deny. Don't you ever say I just walked away. I will always want you. I can live a lie, running for my life. I will always want you. I came in like a wreck. Say I just walked away, I will always want you.
Alright, finally, we have You Give Love a Bad Name, another returning artist, Bon Jovi. This song, I might like it just about as much as Living on a Prayer. They're both great, so it's hard to decide, but it's a banger regardless. I've kind of been wanting it in the game for a while. It's great to see it. And this chart is great too. It includes, like, the guitar solo. And the standard was already actually a very good normal. Memorable, honestly, especially because of the song. Or the song helps it. But even the chart itself was great. And same here. Kind of gives off Heads Explode Deluxe. That solo. The staircases or whatever there. Sweeps. Whatever you want to call them. Some interesting rail holds, honestly. Pretty long, goes across the whole screen. I think there are two of them. And some doubles, swipes. Really good rail holds. Just like the standard had, like, some good swipes and hold swipes. This one goes with rail holds for those parts, which is cool. I thought it would. And this one just does not disappoint. So, let's get into it.
Shout to the heart, and you're too late, darling, you give love a bad name.
Alright, so that's going to wrap up my Season 36 Jukebox Jam ranking slash review video for the Deluxes. Overall, great season, definitely S tier in my opinion. At first I thought A, but now I think it's even better. Deserves S. Can't let something like the Deluxe Normal ruin it. It wasn't even bad. So, yeah, and some record breakers in the, even the Standard, actually. Swamp Thing is the highest note count for Standard and Deluxe. In A Dream of a Night in Mexico is the highest note count hard in the game. So, lots of great things this season. Despite the thing going around about that one's song title, it was really great. And so were the others. So, again, we're nearing 300 subscribers, so please consider liking and subscribing if you enjoyed the video and the rest of my content. I hope you enjoyed. Thank you for watching, and I'll see you in the next one.